In the high-stakes world of basketball recruiting, the search for talent begins early. Kids as young as 9 or 10 are scrutinized, and those without a strong support system can find the process overwhelming.
I grew up in a single-parent household with my mother. She passed away when I was 12. You know, there's some things that I always keep with my mother. You know, when I was about 11 years old, she gave me this speech, you know, that I could be, that I was special, and that I could be, you know, whatever I wanted to be and do whatever I wanted to do. And that's something that I kind of always keep with me, and that kind of, like, gets me through the hard times.
Lamar was taken in by his grandmother, but the pain of his mother's death stayed with him. For solace, he turned to the game he loved and became a star.
5-20, hold on. Big fella, to the basket. Sweeping move inside by Lamar Odom.
It wasn't long before high school coaches from around the country took notice, pulling Lamar in many different directions.
It was mind-boggling at times, you know. Sometimes, you know, you can't even grasp on of it. You need someone to tell you, you know, what to do and how to do it. I didn't have the right people telling me what to do, you know. And a couple of bad decisions myself, you know, didn't help.
But while he excelled on the court, Lamar struggled in the classroom, attending three different high schools during his senior year. It was a lonely, difficult time.
You know, my grandmother raised me, but a 72-year-old lady, she don't know about how crazy and nasty the recruiting process for a high school kid can be, or, you know, a college kid. So I basically felt like I had to raise myself up to some point.
After first committing to UNLV, Lamar finally ended up at the University of Rhode Island.
I was just looking for stability, you know, someplace that I can call home, play basketball, and go to school.
Odom played 1 year there, leading the Rams into the NCAA tournament.
30 feet away, jumper in the air, he's got it! Lamar Odom has won it for Rhode Island!
The next stop, the NBA draft.
That's what I've been waiting for my whole life. I'll tell you the truth, is to hear David Stern call my name and say Lamar Odom. You know, I didn't care what team it was for. I just wanted to hear Mr. Stern call my name.
The Los Angeles Clippers select Lamar Odom from the University of Rhode Island.
With his grandmother by his side, Lamar had achieved his lifelong dream. The journey that began in Queens was finally complete.
We are seeing a star born right here tonight.
And he's done nothing but be a professional. I think he's gone out of his way with the media, with the fans, with everyone involved to show that, you know, he loves the game of basketball. He loves to compete, and he's a good young man.
That was my fault, but be ready, son. You know I'm coming to you, don't say? Use him. Thank you.
Lamar, make a good heads-up play here now. They're going to come after you, all right? You got to make the good play, all right?
Odom with 5 on the clock against Garnett. Here's the matchup. No contest!
Odom has overcome the doubters and the Clippers losing to become a rising star.
In a lot of ways, it made me stronger. Because, you know, I've been through a lot, you know, just to get to this level. You know, I think I was going through a lesson, and I'm glad I went through it. Because if I didn't go through what I went through, I don't think I'd be the person I am today.
He has become one of the league's top rookies. Lamar often thinks of his mother, whose name he writes on his sneakers before each game.
I think she would be proud just to say that her son is in the NBA. You know, not that she's financially okay or, you know, all right. I think she would be proud just to say that her son is in the NBA and made it.